Hi viewers, welcome to JSM. Now we are going to discuss about Langmuir adsorption isotherm. Okay, firstly, what does the isotherm means is a graph drawn at constant temperature. Okay, a graph drawn at a constant temperature is called as isotherm. Okay, so what are the assumptions of this Langmuir for creating the adsorption isotherm are, firstly, he considered a solid surface. Okay, he considered a solid surface, that is adsorbent. Okay, he considered this adsorbent as homogeneous in nature. Okay, he considered it as homogeneous in nature. Homogeneous means the composition of the adsorbent is same at everywhere in its medium. Okay, the composition of the adsorbent is same at everywhere in the medium. That is the term homogeneous means. Okay, so on this adsorbent, he found that there are fixed number of adsorption sites. Okay, there are fixed number of adsorption sites. Okay, so if I consider 1 gram of adsorbent, then it has approximately 20 adsorbate sites. Okay, in the same way, if you consider 2 gram of substance, it is having 40 adsorption sites. Okay, so that is according to the fixed number of adsorption sites. Okay, then he considered each adsorption site. Okay, each adsorption site can accumulate, okay, can accumulate only one adsorbate molecule. Okay, he considered that each adsorption site is accumulating or it is taking only one adsorbate molecule. Therefore, he considered adsorption as only monolayer process. Okay, he considered adsorption as monolayer process. According to this Langmuir, always adsorption is a equilibrium process. Okay, so what is happening at this equilibrium position is the rate of adsorption is equal to the rate of desorption. Okay, this desorption process we can consider as evaporation, and this adsorption process we can consider as condensation. Because what is happening, desorption means the movement of adsorbate molecules from surface to the surroundings, that is from liquid state it is entering into the gaseous state, whereas in case of adsorption, the gaseous molecules of adsorbate are condensing into the liquid state and are sticking to the surface of adsorbent. Okay, so that is why we are considering this rate of adsorption as rate of condensation and rate of desorption as rate of evaporation. And he considered mainly the adsorption process as equilibrium process. So that is why the rate of adsorption is equal to the rate of desorption. Okay, then coming to the fifth point, that is, he said that the rate of condensation, okay, rate of evaporation is always directly proportional to the number of sites occupied. Okay, always the rate of evaporation is directly proportional to the number of this adsorption side occupied by the adsorbate molecules. That is given as rate of evaporation is directly proportional to the theta. Here theta is indicating the number of sites occupied by adsorbate molecule. Okay, by adsorbate molecule. Okay, if you remove this proportionality, you will get a proportionality constant called as evaporation constant. Rate of evaporation is equal to the kd into theta. Okay, kd into theta. This is a proportionality constant for evaporation. Next, rate of condensation is equal to, okay, rate of condensation at any given temperature is directly proportional to the pressure and the number of sites unoccupied by the adsorbent. If you consider the number of adsorbent sites as unity, then the number of sites occupied here is theta. Then what will be the number of unoccupied sites? That will be 1 minus theta. Okay, rate of condensation is directly proportional to the pressure and the number of sites unoccupied. That is number of sites unoccupied. Okay, number of sites unoccupied. So from this inference, okay, from these points, if you consider the rate of evaporation is equal to rate of condensation at equilibrium. Now let us remove this proportionality constant. If we are going to remove this proportionality constant, we'll get rate of condensation is equal to the pressure and the proportionality constant, that is Ka into 1 minus theta. You can also write this equation as Ka into P, that is Ka into P into 1 minus Ka into P into theta, that is Ka P theta. Here Ka is indicating proportionality constant for condensation. Okay, so we have said that according to the Langmuir adsorption isotherm, what is that? At equilibrium, okay, adsorption process is occurring at equilibrium, that is rate of evaporation is equal to the rate of condensation, that is rate of adsorption is equal to the rate of desorption. So that, what is the rate of evaporation now from the previous statements? It is Kd into theta. Therefore, what is the rate of condensation? Is equal to Ka into P minus Ka into P theta. Okay, if you just bring the theta terms towards left side, Kd theta minus plus Ka into P theta is equal to Ka into P. Okay, so if you take the theta common, theta is equal to Kd plus Ka into P is equal to Ka P. Therefore, you just keep the theta this side and take these terms towards that side. Therefore, theta is equal to Ka into P by Kd plus Ka into P. Okay, if you divide the whole thing on the left side by Kd, okay, then you will get theta is equal to Ka by Kd into P by Kd by Kd plus Ka by Kd into P. Here Kd, Kd cancels. Therefore, theta is equal to, if you consider this Ka by Kd is equal to B, then it can be taken as Bp by 1 plus Bp. Okay, so this is the formula for theta. We got the equation. Theta is equal to Bp by 1 plus Bp. Here theta means the number of sites occupied. Okay, always the extent of adsorption is nothing but the number of sites occupied by the adsorbate molecules. Therefore, we can also take this rate of evaporation, okay, as extent of adsorption, because here theta is indicating number of sites occupied. Okay, that is nothing but the extent of adsorption. Therefore, extent of adsorption x by m is equal to Kd into theta. Okay, therefore theta, already we have got the value that Bp by 1 plus Bp. Therefore, extent of adsorption is equal to Kd into Bp by 1 plus Bp. Here we will get a new constant called as A, which is equal to the product of the proportionality constant of evaporation into B is equal to A. Therefore, X by M is equal to AP by 1 plus BP. Okay, we can also write this equation as M by X. Okay, M by X is equal to, see, 1 by AP plus BP by AP. I have just differentiating these terms. What I am doing is, I am taking denominator to numerator and numerator to denominator, and I am dividing those. So 1 by AP plus BP by AP. Okay, it is now in the form of Y is equal to MX plus C. Here P and P get cancelled, and it is in the form of Y is equal to 1 by A here is M, and 1 by P here is X plus C. Here the Y intercept is B by A. Generally we call this equation as the Langmuir adsorption equation. Okay, Langmuir adsorption equation. So the graph drawn from this equation is called as Langmuir adsorption isotherm. Okay, so if you draw the graph, what you are going to get? I am going to draw the graph this side. So here, what is the y-axis there? M by x, right? M by x. And what is the y-intercept? Sorry, y-intercept is already M by x. And what is x-intercept? 1 by p. So 1 by p is the x-intercept here. Okay, and what is the y-intercept? B by a. Okay, if you consider this, it is a y-intercept that is equal to B by a. And what is the slope? 1 by a. Okay, this graph is indicating Langmuir adsorption isotherm, and x by m is equal to AP by 1 plus BP is the Langmuir adsorption equation. Thank you.